Oh no, replied she, they checked that with me. I said, no, tell it plain, I'm leaving now. Well, she lived in a part of the city where folks like me only pass through. Well, I'm captains, bank presidents, and doctors for the residents, and the houses are all massive and huge. As I drove up the half-mile-long driveway, there in the heat of the day, in the bright sunlight gleamed the plane of my dreams, just $65 away. The cockpit was lined with white sheepskin, the instruments carefully placed.
Poor girl.
Computer you read through
not
a tiny TV, and the 10-function program worked great. A small fridge in front of the trailer dispensed either water or wine. Draft beer or iced tea, but what was boggling to me was for $65, it was mine. Well, I thought that the woman must be crazy to be selling this plane at that price. But as she walked down the lane, she seemed perfectly sane. She was charming and really quite nice. She smiled with complete satisfaction as she handed me the title and the key. I said, I just got to know why you've let this thing go. What's wrong with the plane? Tell me, please.
What is it?
She said, I'll be 50 next Tuesday.
So young.
I've lived here with my husband Earl, and after 30 years wed, without a word said, he left me for a young teenage girl. With his credit card here on the table, I knew she'd be hard to maintain. Last month from Florida, he's sent a wire to me, said I need money, dear.
Lesson. She's cheaper to stay with your first wife.